Dear students, today we start colligative properties. So consider a solute as well as solvent. For example, we take sodium chloride in water. Okay. So before adding the solute sodium chloride, the water is tasteless in nature. It does not have any taste. You just add sodium chloride in water and its nature will be salty. Instead of sodium chloride, you can take another solute, sugar. So add sugar in water. Its nature will be different. It will be sweet in taste. So the solvent will be as such. The nature of solvent will be changed by the addition of solute. So overall the solution will have a different nature. This is mainly due to the solute. Okay. There are certain properties which will not depend on chemical nature of solute. First one, relative lowering of vapor pressure, or simply lowering of vapor pressure. Second one, elevation of boiling point. Third one, depression in freezing point. Fourth one, osmotic pressure. So these are all certain properties which will not depend on the chemical nature of solute. These will depend only on the number of particles present in the solution. Okay. So these are called colligative properties. Colligative properties are depending only on number of particles present in the solution. It will not depend on chemical nature. Okay. So one by one we are going to discuss. First one, relative lowering of vapor pressure. We already discussed this one. When a non-volatile solute is added in solvent, the vapor pressure of solution is reduced. So there is a lowering of vapor pressure for the solution. And we relate this lowering of vapor pressure with vapor pressure of pure solvent. It is called a relative lowering of vapor pressure. So already we discussed. And we have derived expressions based on Raoult's law. Okay. So the same concept. We take non-volatile electrolyte, and it should be non-electrolyte. So we are going to take a solute. It should be a non-volatile in nature as well as non-electrolyte. So if you take sodium chloride, means it will be separated into Na plus and Cl minus. You should not take this type of solute. So non-electrolyte type of solute should be taken. When it is added with a solvent, what about vapor pressure of solution? Comparing the vapor pressure of pure solvent, vapor pressure of solution is reduced. For that, explanation is given in page number 50. So when you take a pure solvent, the pure solvent is taken in a closed system. The pure solvent is taken. Now it is in liquid state. And it will be in equilibrium with its vapor. So this we discussed already. So when we take a substance in a particular physical state, it will be in equilibrium with other physical states. When temperature changes, it will be moved into the other physical states. So if you take liquid water, it will be in equilibrium with water vapors, isn't it? So you can take any pure solvent like water, and this will be in equilibrium with its vapor. Liquid solvent will be in equilibrium with its vapor. At equilibrium, in thermodynamics we studied, free energy change will be zero. Free energy change of the solvent in the liquid as well as gaseous phase will be zero. Okay. So this is for pure solvent. In a closed system, we take only pure solvent. It will be in equilibrium with its vapor. Liquid will be in equilibrium with its vapor. So free energy will be zero for both liquid as well as vapor phase. Now we add a non-volatile, non-electrolyte solute with this solvent, and it becomes a solution. When solute is added with this liquid solvent, and the equilibrium is disturbed, isn't it? So to balance the equilibrium, there will be some changes. To attain the equilibrium again, there will be some changes. The change is nothing but lowering of vapor pressure. Okay. Vapor pressure is reduced, then only equilibrium will be attained again. So when solute is added with liquid solvent, randomness increases, entropy value increases. When entropy value increases, means free energy value decreases. When a non-volatile solute is added with liquid solvent, randomness or entropy increases. That means free energy will be decreased. So change in free energy decreases. So there is a disturbance in the equilibrium in the left hand side. So to balance that, there should be some changes. Okay. So the only way of reducing free energy value in the right hand side, vapor pressure decreases. So left hand side, with solvent we add solute, free energy decreases. So this side also free energy has to be decreased for that. Vapor pressure is reduced. The vapor pressure is reduced to maintain the equilibrium. So this is the explanation why the vapor pressure of a solution is lower than the vapor pressure of pure solvent. So according to Raoult's law, we have already derived the formula of relative lowering of vapor pressure. Vapor pressure of pure solvent minus vapor pressure of solution. So this is the difference in vapor pressure. Simply it can be denoted as delta P. So this is the vapor pressure of the solute, isn't it? Solution minus solvent means remaining one more component is solute. So difference in the vapor pressure. So this is nothing but vapor pressure of solute. Okay, what is the denominator value? Vapor pressure of solvent. And this relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of solute. Okay. Using the Raoult's law, we have already derived this equation. Vapor pressure of pure solvent minus vapor pressure of solution divided by vapor pressure of pure solvent is equal to mole fraction of solute B. And this vapor pressure is related with the vapor pressure of pure solvent. So this is called a relative lowering of vapor pressure. So from this relationship, we can prove that lowering of vapor pressure, relative lowering of vapor pressure is a colligative property. What is the definition for colligative property? It will not depend on nature. It will depend only on how much particles present. So this is the colligative property. Relative lowering of vapor pressure is directly proportional to number of particles. Mole fraction is nothing but water. How much particles present in the total number of particles. So this is directly proportional to number of particles present in the solution. So this is a colligative property. Relative lowering of vapor pressure is a colligative property. And what is its application? With the help of this colligative property, we can calculate molar mass of a component like a solute or molar mass of solvent. All these can be calculated. So now we are going to derive an expression for calculating molar mass of solute. So first we have to know what is the formula for mole fraction. So mole fraction is nothing but number of moles of that component divided by total number of moles. Take solvent. Component A is nothing but a solvent. So mole fraction of solvent is equal to number of moles of component A, that means solvent, divided by total number of moles. Na plus Nb. All these we already completed in gas state lesson and in solution lesson also. So number of moles of solvent divided by total number of moles in the solution. What about mole fraction of component B, solute? Number of moles of component B divided by total number of moles. What is the formula for number of moles? Given mass divided by molar mass. This is the formula. Given mass W, molar mass capital M. Okay. If you take solvent, number of moles of solvent is equal to weight of solvent divided by molar mass of solvent. Number of moles of solute, weight of solute WB divided by molar mass of solute MB. So lowering of vapor pressure. Delta P is nothing but what? Lowering of vapor pressure. Vapor pressure of pure solvent minus vapor pressure of solution divided by vapor pressure of pure solvent. The solvent is denoted as component A. It can also be written as P naught A is equal to XB. So this is the expression obtained in Raoult's law. Using Raoult's law, we have obtained this expression. So instead of XB, mole fraction of solute, we may write it as NB divided by Na plus Nb. So comparing the solute, solvent will always be in a larger quantity. Generally, solute will be in lesser quantity. Solvent will be in larger quantity. So Na value is greater than Nb, so that this term can be rearranged as Na. The total number of moles can be assumed as Na. Okay. Number of moles of solute is equal to Wb divided by Mb. Then divided by number of moles of solvent, W A divided by M A. So we rearrange this, lowering of vapor pressure to the vapor pressure of pure solvent is equal to W B by W A into M A by M B. So using this expression, we can find molar mass of solvent, solute, and so on. Okay. So except MB, if you know all other values, we can calculate molar mass of solute. So we will do a problem. Example, problem number 3. an aqueous solution of 2% non-volatile solute. So the given data is, we have an aqueous solution with 2% concentration, okay, 2% of non-volatile solute in the solution. So 2% non-volatile solute means weight of solute is equal to 2 gram, weight of solvent will be 98 gram. So given data, 2% aqueous solution containing non-volatile solute, and this solution is experiencing the pressure 1.004 bar. Okay, so pressure of solution is equal to 1.004 bar. Vapor pressure of pure solvent is 1.013 bar. Calculate molar mass of solute. We have to calculate molar mass of solute. So what is the formula? Vapor pressure of pure solvent minus vapor pressure of solution divided by vapor pressure of pure solvent is equal to WB divided by WA, MA divided by MB. Okay. So pure solvent, vapor pressure of pure solvent 1.013 minus vapor pressure of solution 1.004 divided by vapor pressure of pure solvent 1.013 is equal to. So right hand side, WB, weight of solute 2 gram. This is molar mass of solvent. In question, they have mentioned as aqueous solution. Aqueous means solvent is water. So its molar mass is 18 gram. Then what is the weight of solvent? 98 gram. And we don't know the molar mass of solute. So MB is equal to 2 into 18 into 1.013 divided by 98 into 0.009. So molar mass of solute is 41.3 gram per mole. So there are 4 colligative properties. Colligative property will depend only on number of particles. It will not depend on the nature of solute in the solution. First colligative property is relative lowering of vapor pressure. For pure solvent, there is a vapor pressure because pure solvent is in equilibrium with its vapors. When a non-volatile and non-electrolyte solute is added in the pure solvent, the solution will have lower vapor pressure. This is mainly due to disturbance in the equilibrium. For equilibrium, free energy change is zero. But when solute is added in the solvent, for the solution, free energy decreases. It will be a negative value. But for vapors, there should be a decrease in free energy to maintain the equilibrium. Left hand side, free energy decreases. Right hand side, free energy has to decrease. For that, we have only one chance: lowering of vapor pressure. So vapor pressure reduces, and we relate this vapor pressure with the pure solvent. Vapor pressure of pure solvent, it is called the relative lowering of vapor pressure. So we have proved, according to Raoult's law, relative lowering of vapor pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction. It will depend only on number of particles. So with this, we complete first colligative property. Second one, elevation of boiling point. that we will discuss tomorrow. Thank you.